Okay, guys, so we're here to do part two of the WWE shakeup and the Smackdown review. So let's start off with what we pretty much know is established, which is there was 14 superstars that were moved to Smackdown, some which were actually added this morning. And we still don't know the situation with Sheamus yet. We don't know if he's still going to be on SmackDown or if he's still in a possibility of being moved. All we know is Alexander Wolf is probably going to be leaving the company. I'm also hearing rumors that he might end up signing with NXT, which actually that's where he got his start anyway. So if they want to move him down there, that's okay. The other thing that I'm hearing is it is official that Ember Moon has also been moved to SmackDown permanently, as well as Mickie James, Bayley, and Liv Morgan actually has also been moved. Lars Sullivan was supposed to be on Monday Night Raw permanently, but they decided that they were going to move him to SmackDown. The other thing that's going on is Heavy Machinery has been officially moved as well, so they will be on SmackDown. Roman Reigns is also officially on SmackDown now, so there will be no, Seth versus Roman anymore. I guess they're going to be going in a completely different direction. We saw a pretty good match on SmackDown between Charlotte Flair and Carmella. I really enjoyed that segment. And R-Truth tried fighting off Lars Sullivan from attacking Carmella. That segment was kind of interesting as well. We get some pretty good competition on SmackDown. I really understand what Vince is kind of going. And then we get the segment where Roman actually physically attacks Vince McMahon and Elias. Elias was also traded to SmackDown. I don't know if I agree with that. I think that that's actually a bad move for Elias. I think that he's just going to get mixed up in the shuffle on that show, but that's just my opinion, honestly. We also got rumors going around right now that Sasha Banks is being not cooperative, I guess. She wants more time basically to figure out what she's going to do here. And from what I'm hearing, it sounds like she might not even be coming back until the week before the Money in the Bank pay-per-view, which is in May. I think May 15th or May 16th, I believe. We also got rumors going around that Luke Harper has granted his release from the company. He no longer wants to be with WWE. He has been interested in pursuing an independent career. I'm actually okay with that for him because, again, when he came back, he only had a few matches. He had a really good showing in the Worlds Collide tournament, but I do think that he would do much better in the Indies, honestly. Now, this past week, Kushida Shane Strickland has reported to the Performance Center along with Robbie E and a bunch of other signings. So it sounds like they're, trying to build up basically NXT again. I think that there's the signings that they have had so far are actually good, honestly, going forward. Shane Strickland will be a great talent for them. Kushida as well. So what would I say about the shakeup so far with both brands? I have to be honest, I feel like Raw kind of won in this situation, because you get AJ Styles, you get great, amazing talent, honestly, going forward. SmackDown, they did get quite a bit of different people going over there, including Finn Balor, which I am very happy for, honestly. Finn needs a whole new start. This is a great opportunity for this guy. So you also switch United States champion Samoa Joe has been drafted to Raw. Then you draft Balor to SmackDown. So the Intercontinental Championship is now on SmackDown, and the United States Championship is now on Raw. I don't think that's ever happened ever in WWE history before that I can remember. So again, it's a whole different playing field. Then you have to consider that SmackDown also has Asuka and Kairi Sane is a tag team now for the women's division. That is going to be great for SmackDown. We still don't really know the situation right now going forward. Like Apollo Crews, which was he was doing nothing on Raw, absolutely nothing. And then Buddy Murphy as well in 205 Live. So you take those guys and you move them over to SmackDown. My concern is, what are you going to do with these guys? I mean, there's literally nothing for these guys to do other than be a tag team. And which I'm fine actually. If they want to go that route, that's fine. The Hardys can fight them. I mean, without the Usos on SmackDown, the tag team division is just gonna have to be completely, honestly, redone now. Like, I don't know. It's just, I don't know. They're gonna have to do something. The women's tag team championship division, I feel like, is gonna get better as time goes on. We just need to have a little bit more patience. I like that Bray Wyatt's coming back sometime soon. That should help WWE out. Sami Zayn turning heel, I think, is gonna be kind of interesting. Oh yeah, and Daniel Bryan was injured at WrestleMania, guys. He is being evaluated. They're not really telling anybody what's going on with his health situation. They're saying that this could be another long-term injury that he might have to take some serious time off to recover from. I'm not happy to hear that, because Daniel Bryan is somebody that the WWE really needs, because he's always put great matches on. He's always been a great competitor, and I think that they would really miss him if he's not around. So going towards Money in the Bank, I think that we're gonna have some great matches ahead of us. And no Brock Lesnar, so let's be happy about that, guys. It sounds like Lesnar's not gonna be back for a very long time, and that's what the company needs. They need to move on from Lesnar. And I don't even know if he's gonna be back anyways because of the incident that happened at WrestleMania. So that's what I just want to talk about was SmackDown. I thought was probably a six this week. Again, with the whole flight issue with the superstars, the segment with Kevin Owens and the New Day, I thought was a little out there. It's not something that they would normally do. I kind of liked it. I thought it was kind of funny, honestly. But I kind of wonder what they're going to be doing with Kevin Owens going forward from this point. He's going to end up having to challenge Finn Balor for a championship, or even Kofi Kingston, honestly, if they want to do that route. Big E is injured right now, so he's going to be out for I don't know how long. They haven't even really said on the website yet. But yeah, that's basically what's going on with the straightforward news as far as what I know, what's going on in the company, the superstars who have been moved over to each brand. I think it's going to be good for both brands going forward. I think SmackDown is going to be better now. Now that you have Finn Balor and a few other the other talents, the women's division will probably be a little bit more interesting. Mickie James gets a whole new start, back on SmackDown. I kind of like that too. But again, Liv Morgan moving over, not quite understanding. I guess they're splitting up the Riot Squad. I guess I don't know. Oh yeah, and WWE will be within negotiations actually to meet with Eli Drake. I've heard some rumors going around that they're going to try to, basically sign him in the next few months. And if they do that, that's actually good. I'm okay with it. He deserves another opportunity. Impact dropped the ball on him. So I think that he deserves another opportunity. But yeah, SmackDown I thought was a better show this week. Better than a few of the past weeks, honestly. Again, the draft is kind of up and down for me. Like, some things make total sense, other things are like, eh, scratch my head, like, whatever. But that's just how I kind of feel about it. And I really liked the Worlds Collide tournament. I watched it on the network, and I really liked it. I thought it was good. So anyways, I'm gonna get out of your hair, and you guys enjoy your week. I just wanted to do this, update for SmackDown and what happened there, and the other news that I'm hearing about the other injuries to the superstars and what's going on with Sasha Banks. Sounds like she's not gonna be back till May, until she figures out what she was gonna do. I would not be surprised if she does not leave the company, honestly, because she is a very talented wrestler. She could go to any company in the world and be successful. So I would not be surprised if she does not leave WWE at some point in time.